things you don't know about Disneyland part 3. Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome to the third part of the video, interesting facts about Disneyland. Make sure to check the first and second part of my video. With that said, let's get back to our discussion topic. The insiders may speak in code to streamline operations, communicating in high stress environments, protect customers from unpleasant events, or shield the public from behind the scenes activities. In the same way, Walt Disney World cast members live and work in a culture requiring them to use code words every day. Pay close attention and you may hear the following secret codes while using your favorite theme park. Cast members, costumes, and roles. The most widely used code word you will hear at Disney World is cast member, a title that applies to its entire staff. The idea Walt wanted to convey when he coined the term was that everyone who worked for him acted in the performance of his theme parks. In keeping with the theatrical lingo, cast members refer to their uniforms as costumes, regardless of their appearance. From the decked-out bellhops at the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror to the janitor who services the restrooms, they all wear costumes. Additionally, cast members are not given a job as we would understand it. Instead, they received a theatrical role to perform, even if the part involves dishing out ice cream or ringing up purchases. On stage, backstage. Using theatrical terminology, cast members divide the theme parks and other resort venues into on-stage and backstage spaces. On-stage areas exist in the public view, so at Walt Disney World, it indicates any place that guests can see or visit. On the other hand, Disney's backstage only allows employees to enter. Of course, if you want to poke around secretive backstage areas, then you can book a special tour for an additional fee. However, don't get any ideas about taking pictures on these tours unless you want to be ejected from the park. Photos are strictly prohibited. Shows, attractions, and parks. Many attractions and shows have designated codes that cast members use while talking to each other. Not all of them can be mentioned here. The list is too long, but some examples include Coaster for Rock and Roll Coaster, GMR for the Great Movie Ride, HOP for the Hall of Presidents, and Beer Band for the Country Beer Jamboree. Also, you may notice a cast member ask another if he has been to MK, which means Magic Kingdom, the Studios, Hollywood Studios, and DAK, Disney's Animal Kingdom.
Code 101. Though this sounds like a police lingo, it actually communicates the functionality of an attraction. Cast members will never tell you that a ride is down or broken. Such a statement may cast a gloomy spirit over your day or cause you anxiety about your safety issues. They usually announce that the ride is temporarily unavailable, but to each other they call it 101. Attractions are identified as code 102 when they resume operations. White powder alert. Some guests love visiting Walt Disney World so much that they want to make it their permanent home forever. You won't find a real cemetery on the Disney property, but a few fans consider having their ashes dumped among the headstones at Haunted Mansion. Whenever park guests try to fulfill the wishes of the dearly departed by spreading their cremated ashes at Walt Disney World, they run the risk of provoking a white powder alert. Cast members use this phrase to report the incident, which results in an immediate evacuation and a code 101 at the attraction where it occurs. Though you may be trying to honor your loved one's wishes, you are actually committing a crime, as Disney does not give permission for guests to spread human remains on its property. Guests producing a white powder alert risk being banned permanently from Disney parks. Code V. The mentioning of code V or signal V occurs more often than cast member would like to admit. Mixing too much food or alcohol with the thrilling attractions around Disney parks occasionally produces vomiting, thereby triggering a code V. Naturally, the protein spill, as the cast member call it, requires instant attention to prevent contamination. In fact, it generates a code 101 if it creates a mess on an attraction. In any case, a cleaning crew will disinfect the area as quickly as possible. Signal 25. Hopefully, a signal 25 does not occur while you are visiting Walt Disney World, but it happened in the past. Cast members send a signal 25 to their co-workers when smoke or fire appears. The code has been used a number of times in the past to deal with the fire emergencies, some of which occurred on the monorail and theme park attractions and during fireworks, presentations and shows with the electrical systems. Fortunately, the Reedy Creek Fire Department effectively handled those emergencies, preventing serious injury and death and providing data to help the resort improve safety. You are not likely to encounter fires the next time you visit in Walt Disney World, but be prepared to evacuate if you hear this code. Signal 70. A cast member used the term Signal 70 when reporting a lost child. The cryptic term prevents parents and other listeners from enticing panic and communicates the situation quickly to cast members to speed up the search. Also, when a lost child interacts with Disney staff during a Signal 70, cast members will dub it a lost parent situation to avoid scaring him or her. If you have the misfortune of experiencing a Signal 70, then it's good to know that cast members will guide your child to a baby care center, where Disney movies, coloring books and the like will occupy them until your reunion. Alpha Unit. When a cast member indicates that an Alpha Unit has arrived, they are referring to emergency first responders. In particular, this points to emergency medical services arriving. Via ambulance in response to a 911 call. Naturally, if you or a loved one suffer from any injury or medical emergency, then you will be comforted when cast members speak of the Alpha Unit arriving to provide assistance. Treasured guest. Perhaps our parents and grandparents speak of us, their treasured children, to communicate the extent of their love for us. But a cast member using the term means something quite different. By all means, Disney prohibits cast members from using negative or insulting language, especially in front of the public. However, tense situations sometimes occur due to a guest's unruly or rude behavior. The cast members need to warn their co-workers about them. They diplomatically refer to the troublesome person as a treasured guest. Number 19. You can now own a piece of Disneyland for $150. For 11 years, Disneyland's Walk of Magical Memories program allowed guests to sponsor personalized 10-inch hexagonal commemorative bags for $150. Annual pass holders receive a 10% discount. Guests who pay for the pavers do not actually own a piece of Disneyland because they did not buy any ownership of the paver, but only the opportunity to have their names put on them. Disneyland stopped accepting new orders at the end of February 2011. These pavers can still be seen in the esplanade between Disneyland Park and Disney California Adventure. Number 20. Mickey Mouse Ear Hearts are the most popular Disneyland Resort souvenirs of all time. The line is taken from Disneyland Resort 59th Anniversary Fun Facts, July 17, 2014, issued by Disneyland Public Relations. Except that MSM left out of the most interesting part. The number sold. The full line was Mickey Mouse Ear Hearts are the most popular Disneyland Resort souvenirs of all time, with more than 84 million ears sold since 1955. The original Mickey Mouse Club television series, famously featuring talented children wearing caps with Mickey Mouse ears, premiered October 3, 1955, less than 3 months after the opening of Disneyland. Immediately, there was synergy between the show and the park. The same Disneyland PR fact sheet also had this. Since opening day in 1955, the Disneyland Resort has welcomed nearly 700 million guests to the happiest place in the earth. That would mean that 1 in 8 bought ears. That seems high, especially because the number 700 million refers to attendance, not unique guests. You really don't see that many guests wearing ears these days, and you did not in the past either. Far more guests wear Disney's t-shirt. The popularity of Disney's pins exploded when Disney Parks announced pin trading at the time of the Millennium Celebration. Pin collectors often own dozens or even hundreds of pins, but there are no published number of t-shirts and pins sold at the Disneyland Resort since 1955. Number 21. All the teacups spinners are same in speed. There is a rumor that the purple teacup and the orange one with diamond shapes on it are the fastest spinners, and the mad tea party ride. All Disneyland teacups are designed to work the same way. Observations about the two fastest teacups were posted on the Hidden Mickey's website in 1955 and 2000, but the legend could be older than that. In early 2004, Disneyland modified the teacups to make them harder to spin around their fixed center wheel. Number 22. Every year, 2.8 million churros are sold at Disneyland. Guests at the Disneyland park alone consumed 4 million hamburgers, 1.6 million hot dogs, 3.4 million hours of french fries, 1.5 million servings of popcorn, 3.2 million servings of ice cream, 1.2 million gallons of soft drink, and 2.8 million churros. Each year, Disneyland resort guests consume 1.6 million servings of popcorn, 3.2 million servings of ice cream, and 2.8 million churros. Attendance is now higher than back then, but the public at large is more conscious of avoiding sugar, fried fats, and empty calories. Still, it's easy to imagine that Disneyland continues to sell around 2.8 million churros annually. Number 23. The gold trimmings on the outside of the It's a Small World ride are made of real 22 karat gold. According to a souvenir book for It's a Small World at Disneyland printed in 1973, for weather durability and unexcelled beauty, 22 karat gold leaf was used for trim throughout the facade. When domestic supplies of gold leaf ran low, Disney engineers secured a European shipment to finish the job, thus adding another international touch while creating a striking contrast of gold textures. Gold leaf is real gold, flattened into thinner than a tissue sheets. Its architectural use is not limited to Disney. For example, the dome of the U.S. State Capitol building in Des Moines is covered with gold leaf. Number 24. Disneyland has in total 18 attractions. It originally opened with 18 attractions, and 14 of them are still around. Number 25. The abominable snowman in the Matterhorn is named Harold. Officially, Disney called him abominable snowman. Unofficially, engineers dubbed him Harold, and that nickname leaked into use by cast members and the public. He has only lived in the Matterhorn since 1978, when the ice pavers were added. Before that, the interior of the Matterhorn was a big hollow space. Number 26. When it opened in 1959, the Disneyland monorail was the first daily operating monorail in the Western Hemisphere. The claim paraphrases the recorded narration on the Disneyland Railroad after it leaves the Toontown train depot. If you look overhead, you might catch a glimpse of monorail. When Disneyland introduced the monorail back in 1959, it was the first daily operating monorail system in the entire Western Hemisphere. Apparently, somebody at MSN thinks the ultimate Disney fan never takes Disneyland Railroad and will thus find the insane fact to be mind-blowing. Number 27. The water features in Disneyland are green or brown to hide the vehicle tracks and filtration system.
Over the years, Disneyland has dyed the water of the rivers of America, Jungle Cruise, and Fantasyland waterways. The color has changed from brown to green to bluish green. The dye prevents guests from seeing the shallow bottom and the guideways for ride vessels. But a blanket statement about the water features in Disneyland is not correct. The submarine lagoon is crystal clear so that guests can see the show scenes. Pirates of the Caribbean and It's a Small World also have clear water. Number 28. The Haunted Mansion has 999 ghosts in it. Disneyland has long boasted there are 999 homes who are dying to meet you, and they always have room for one more. As guests approach the loading area for the doom baggage, the voice of the ghost host intones, "Actually, we have 999 happy homes here, but there's room for 1,000. Do we have any volunteers? If you insist on lagging behind, we may not need to volunteer." These are clever and memorable lines, but they are not meant as an actual count of how many ghostly figures are in the ride show scenes. Number 29. Disneyland Park announcer Bill Roger and California Adventure Park announcer answer, Camille Dixon are married. This was the subject of a Disney Parks blog entry. Behind the scenes made Disneyland Resort Park. Announcer Bill and Camille by Shannon Swanson. Public Relations Manager Disneyland Resort on September 24, 2012. Number 30. Club 33 is the only location in Disneyland where you can buy alcohol. Unless you are a Club 33 member or the guest of one, Club 33 is just a locked door in New Orleans Square. At Disney California Adventure, Downtown Disney and the three hotels of the Disneyland Resort, adults can easily purchase alcohol. The absence of alcohol, not even wine with a table service dinner in Disneyland, is a holdover from a policy established by Walt Disney. Guests at Magic Kingdom Park at Walt Disney World can have wine at the Be Our Guest restaurant, but otherwise the park is dry too. Any of the US Disney parks that don't have a cafe in the middle have full bars. We are at many counter service restaurants and kiosks selling alcoholic beverages for consumption while walking around the park. It remains to be seen how long Disney continues to leave money on the table by keeping Disneyland dry for anyone who can't get into Club 33, which means almost everyone. So many other things are done differently now than when Walt Disney was around. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check the other two parts and upcoming parts of the Disneyland video. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button below, and please don't forget to share this video with your friends.